Create a line chart showing total monthly profit. That's it. It just works. This is Quadratic, a spreadsheet that responds like ChatGPT. While Excel's AI tools are slowly rolling out, Quadratic is already there, and I'm partnering with them to give you full pro access free for a month. Click the first link below to get started and grab the sample files in the second link to follow along. Let's go.
From the homepage, click the Open Quadratic button to get started. And once you sign up for an account, come meet me on the app's homepage. Let's jump in and create your first sheet. Click the plus icon on the Files menu option to get started. Okay, so it looks like a spreadsheet with columns and rows, but don't blink because this one can think. Open up the folder of files to follow along with, then watch what happens when I drag and drop this donut profit file into a cell. Instant table. Now this data set shows the monthly profit by donut flavor across every one of my David's Donut Den stores across the United States. So imagine you've got some data like this and your boss comes in and asks for a rolling 12-month profit report by store and by flavor. In Excel, that's a nightmare formula that looks like this. But in this AI spreadsheet, you just ask. Over here in the sheet chat window, you can submit any request and then press enter to submit it. Immediately, the AI processes your request, translates it into code, and adds the rolling profit. The whole operation takes about 15 seconds, and you'll notice there's a new table created to prevent contaminating your original data set. Let's just double check a row to see if it got it right. I'll scroll back over to check out apple fritters on the original data set. First though, let's clean up the column so that we can view all this data on one page. In March, we got 3,000, April was 2,200, and May was 2,100. You can see the sum in the bottom right, and that matches the rolling profit that Quadratic's AI gave us.
Pop quiz time. Now, what Excel formula has racked up more views on this channel than any other? VLOOKUP. And now it's time to bury it. Let's actually forget how to use it, because Quadratic just does what you want.
Let's scroll to the right and make some space for some new data. This time, let's pull in the Donut Den addresses so we can pull in the state information to our table. And heads up, this isn't a typical VLOOKUP because the state is embedded inside of the address field. Next, click on the original table where it says Python 1. Then click the drop-down arrow and select Open Code Editor. Here you've got all the Python logic which calculated rolling profit. Now you can make changes to this code, which I'll show you later, but let's go to the code chat first. Anything I ask here will only impact the current table. And for multi-step tasks like this one, I get better results by turning on think mode. So the AI works through the problem step by step before rushing in. And that's it. Quadratic added that state column in near real time with Python running under the hood. Now, if you don't like a change, you can always reject it with this giant red button. Then you try asking the AI in a different way. But this is exactly what we needed to bury VLOOKUP, so let's click the accept button. Now, let's have some fun and bury chart building too. In Excel, if I took this data set and I wanted the profit by state for 2024, I'd have to figure out the group by formula, and filters, maybe even Power Query. And at the end of all of that, I'd probably still end up with a chart that looked like this. Back in Quadratic, I can ask for a bar chart and just press enter. And let's say you don't like something about what pops up. You can edit it just like we edited the table. For example, let's just ask for the top 10 states instead. Another couple seconds later, and your chart's ready to go. The AI can handle some pretty vague prompts too, just like make the colors better, which added column borders and grid lines to make a more visually appealing chart. Finally, the legend is pretty weird, so let's get rid of it. This is looking pretty good. Now, this isn't a static screenshot either. You can zoom in by clicking and dragging. You can zoom out by double clicking. And you can hover over any data point for more information. And that's all good, but as you know, spreadsheets aren't all about visuals. It's important to get the basics right too. So for example, you can still format things with a click. You can move tables and charts around just by clicking and dragging them. You can still use formulas if you want. So let's try summing a few numbers here. And of course it's collaborative. Real-time edits show up instantly, just like Google Sheets. So yeah, it handles the familiar stuff, but what about data you've never touched before? Let's raise the stakes and pull in our last data set, student test scores. Now, normally to learn a new data set, you'd scroll through the rows, maybe build some pivot tables, basically waste time trying to make sense of it all. But with Quadratic, you've got a new way of looking at data. So let's just ask it to find the insights in this data set. And after about 15 seconds, you're left with this. Let's check the chat first. So first up, we've got some basic statistics if we scroll left. That's not so helpful, so let's move on to the correlation heat map. And now we're getting somewhere because we see that test score and attendance have a pretty decent correlation between the two. Going right even further, we can see the average test scores, and we've got a summary of all these insights. So you get up to speed much faster, plus you can keep asking questions to dive deeper.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Should I rebuild my entire life inside Quadratic? Well, hold up a sec, because if you've used Excel or Google Sheets for years, there are a few things that will trip you up. For example, double-clicking to auto-resize all the columns across the sheet doesn't work yet. You also can't use formulas inside tables, but the Quadratic team's working on this one. There aren't any pivot tables. Everything's just handled through Python and AI instead. And while there's no hard row limit, huge files can lag in your browser. As of filming, there's also an AI cap of 20 messages per month on the free tier. After that, queries slow down by about 10 seconds, but you're not totally shut out. So yeah, Quadratic has some rough edges, but if you're willing to think differently, it is more than just a spreadsheet. It is an entire data laboratory.
You can run machine learning algorithms directly in your spreadsheet. Afterwards, you can inspect the results using the code editor that we've seen before, make direct changes to the Python code, and rerun it. This shows you new results that you can continue to refine. You can even import data through an API. Check out this request to get top stories from the New York Times. And finally, you can query databases with zero SQL skills. I'm going to connect to a database of RNA sequence data. Then when I click on the connection, I can just describe what I want in the code chat and the AI takes over. It generates the right SQL, pulls the right data into the spreadsheet, and off you go.
You've just seen the future of spreadsheets available right now. No formulas to memorize or menus to dig through. Thanks so much for watching. Now's your chance to try it free. 1 month of Pro, unlimited AI, no strings. Click the link in the description to get started and drop a comment on what you want to see me break down next. I'll see you in the next one.